Hello students, in this video we are going to discuss operations on rational number. In previous videos, maybe two or three videos are there, we all discussed about rational numbers, their properties and how we solve all the questions of comparing of rational number to arrangement of rational number. In this video, we are going to discuss operations on rational number. So let's start. As we know that there are four basic operations in mathematics. They are addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So we discussed how we perform these four operations on a rational number. Later we discuss different properties with examples taken from your exercises. So first one is addition, how we add two rational numbers. So let me rub the board first. We are discussing about addition. Suppose there are two rational numbers where A upon B and C upon D. Clear? All these four are different integers and B not equal to 0. All are integers but B and D not equals to 0. Individually B not equal to 0, D not equal to 0. So how we add them? So we must add a plus sign just in front of the division line or rational number line. Clear? How we perform? I am giving you some general concept, then we discuss question by using your exercise. See the denominator. First we make the denominator positive. That we discussed in last videos. First we make the denominator positive, then after we take the LCM of these two denominators. Suppose the LCM is BD. So then we draw a big line and write down at the denominator of LCM BD. Divide this BD by B. What is the quotient? Quotient is your D only. And that quotient multiplied by A. So here we have AD. Means whenever we divide BD by B, we have a quotient D and that quotient is multiplied by the numerator, first numerator. Similarly, second denominator, we divide LCM by second denominator. What is the quotient? Quotient is B. So we multiply it by the quotient to the second numerator. It's a BC. Now later we add these two and get the result. For example, now see the example. I am solving example this side. See, here it's given that 4 upon 9 plus 2 upon 9. Since here denominators are same, but use a general concept so that you people never confuse. So what is our work? We will find out the LCM of 9. Let me rub this side. Okay, find this side and LCM of 9 and 9. 2 9 is there. So 9 divided by 9, 1 1. So LCM is 9. So you must write down here 9. clear? So now 9 is there, 9 is here, 9 divided by 9, it's a 1, and that 1 multiplied by the numerator, 4, 4 into 1, 4, give a plus sign, as it is, pick the sign, plus, again 9 divided by 9, it's a 1, 1 multiplied by 2, it's a 2, it's a 6 upon 9. Clear? Now if we see these two, in this 2 there is a common multiple 3. No, we can write down 3 into 2 or 3 into 3. 9, 3 into 3, 6, 3 into 2, 3 is common multiple. So ultimately what we have? Ultimately we can write down this as a 2 upon 3. You may or may not write this part. That doesn't matter. Clear? So hope this will clear to you. Now move to the next operation, subtraction. Subtraction is as same as your addition, simply sign is different. Means here also A, B minus C, D is there. So take the LCM, B, D. Divide BD by B, first denominator, it's D. Multiply first denominator by D, it's AD minus. Divide BD by D, second denominator, we have B. So B into C. Now, for your benefit, I am solving one question. The same question, previous question, it's a 4 upon 9. If this question is given to you, means we are going to perform subtraction by using these two rational numbers. So what is our first work? Our first work, we first take the LCM of both denominator. It's a 9. Not only 2, if more than 2 or 3 is given, doesn't matter. Take the LCM together. 9 1 is 9, 4 minus 2. Similarly, we know 9 1 is 9, 2 into 2, 1. So 2 upon 9. This is the answer. Likewise, you have to perform subtraction 1. Now, multiplication and division. Next one is your multiplication. Suppose we have, similarly, we have AB multiplied by C into D. Always remember that sign between two rational numbers must be written in the mid of these two rational numbers. No? Not only distance wise, but see this one also. In front of this, you can put the sign. Be careful. Now, how we multiply? Now, see here, first numerator multiplied by second numerator, and first denominator multiplied by second denominator. So it's a AC by BD. Likewise, this is simple multiplication. It's the easiest one. Now what about division? I'm going to discuss division this side. In case of division, A upon B, again C upon D, this is this one, no? Then remember, always give equal to sign whenever you begin the new line, and if there is an equation, then use implies that sign. Okay, note down first part, this is first part, this is second part, this is a divide sign. A upon B, as it is, change the divide sign to multiply sign, and on the same time reciprocate the second part. Reciprocate means just invert the position of the number, invert the position of numerator and denominator. Numerator goes to denominator, denominator goes to numerator. Likewise, D to upon C. Likewise, D is denominator here, here it's a numerator. C is numerator, here it is denominator. This is the process. Now follow the process of multiplication. Numerator multiplied by numerator, it's AD. Denominator multiplied by denominator, BC. Then after, if you have any common multiple, we can divide. This is a general concept. By doing performance or solving the questions by using some digits or some rational numbers, we have some more tricks to solve easily that we discuss later. So this is the concept. So now I am going to give you some examples so that you can easily understand. Then we move to the exercise. Now, using the same number, 4 upon 9 multiplied by 2 upon 9. What I told you, that numerator multiplied by numerator, 4 into 2. Denominator multiplied by denominator, it's 8 upon 81. Clear? Now come for division. Same rational number I am using, 4 upon 9 divided by 2 upon 9. What I told you, first we change the sign, pick first rational number as it is, change the divide sign into multiply sign, then reciprocate the second rational number, always remember, not the first one, always only reciprocate this one. It's a strict rule. Now, here it's a 4 into 9 multiplied numerator to numerator, denominator to denominator, and 9 into 2. Clear? Now, in this case, what we can, either in this case or this case, see if in this case numerator and denominator having same terms with multiply sign, remember, with multiply sign, if there is a plus sign and minus sign, we not perform this one. If multiply sign is given, then we can easily cut same type of number or divide by each other. 9 and write down 9 1 9 9 1 9. Clear? Now here see 4 and 2, 2 can divide 4. So 2 1 2 2 2 4. Now what we have ultimately we have 2 into 1 by 1 into 1, we can write down 2 upon 1 or equals to 2, sorry, equals to 2. Now hope this one is clear to you. Now I am going to discuss question answers given in your exercise. Now we are going to discuss some questions based on your today's discussion. First question is, add the following rational number. Add the following rational numbers. Line little bit not straight, I think. So please avoid this one. Question says that we have to add minus 14 upon 23 plus within bracket 9 upon 23. Though in question it is not given bracket, you have to use your common sense and apply bracket. If there is two opposite signs are given, in this case we have minus, in this case we have plus, so we have to use in bracket, and in between these two number we insert the addition sign. Now first we remove the bracket so that we can easily understand which one is
plus 9 upon 23. Again here LCM is same, denominator is same, so we can write down easily 23. It's a 23 1 is 23, so it's a minus 14. Remember, for this denominator, this rational number, we have this sign. So 23 divided by 23, it's a 23 divided by 23, it's a 1. 1 into 14 is a 14, but there is a negative sign in front of the rational number, so we insert the negative sign. Now again, in this case, in front of this rational number, we have positive sign. So insert positive sign, 23, 1, 23, it's a 9. Now perform the operation. Here we have two opposite signs, so operation is subtraction. So it's a 14, 9 minus 14, or you can say minus 14 plus 9, it's a minus 5 upon 23. This is the solution. One more question of same negative sign. We are going to discuss one more question for same negative sign. It's a minus 5 upon 12, within bracket, we are performing addition, plus minus 7 upon 9. Always follow the brackets, use each and every part, because you are a little bit in higher classes. Now then, write down, remove the bracket, write down plus into minus, minus 7 upon 9. Now take the LCM of 12 and 9. In rough, 12 and 9, it's a 3, 4s are 3, 3s are 36. It's a 36. Now divide 36 by 12, we have 3. Multiply 3 with 5, we have 15. But we replace the sign of this part, it's a negative one. Again, here we have negative sign. So place it negative. 36 divided by 9, it's a 4. 4 multiplied by 7, it's a 28. Now what we are observing, they are same sign. So same sign must be added. So 8, 5, 13. 1 carry, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, minus. And sign of both is same. So we use same sign. So this is your solution. Okay. Now I want to discuss one more question of this type. Now, as you are observing on the screen, there is one more question for addition. We have to add this rational number to this rational number. What we are observing in this case, this is your mixed fraction. This one is your mixed fraction. And this one is a rational number with two negative integer. So what is our work? We have to remove the bracket and simplify first. First, we simplify them into make from mixed fraction to improper fraction. 6 into 3, it's 18, and this 18 is added to 5, it's 23 upon 6. Plus, now see here, there are two same sign, and this line is used for division. So here, two same sign gives you the positive result, though here we have negative. So we can write down 5 upon 12. Now remove the bracket. We have 23 upon 6 plus 5 upon 12. Now take the LCM of 6 and 12. LCM of 6 and 12 is 6. Sorry, is 12. 6 2s are 23, 2s are 46 plus 5. I can write down it's a 51 upon 12. This is your solution. Now I'm going to discuss this video's last question. Now, लास्ट क्वेश्चन टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सिंप्लीफिकेशन और सिंप्लीफाई टाइप क्वेश्चन. इट सेज दैट सिंप्लीफाई ना सिंप्लीफाई. आई एम पिकिंग द लास्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस बुक एंड दिस वन इज इंटरेस्टिंग वन. सिंप्लीफाई 4 whole 1/5 प्लस विद इन ब्रैकेट माइनस 5 whole 3/10 प्लस 1 whole 1/2. क्लियर? दिस इज योर दिस वन इज योर प्रॉब्लम. इन दिस केस वी हैव एडिशन साइन एंड वी ऑल्सो हैव सब्ट्रैक्शन साइन और माइनस साइन. हाउ वी सॉल्व दिस कॉम्बिनेशन? लेट्स स्टार्ट. फर्स्ट वी कन्वर्ट देम इनटू इम्प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शन. सो 4 5s are 20 प्लस 1 21/5 प्लस माइनस 5 10 50 प्लस 3 53/10 प्लस 2 1s are 2 प्लस 1 3/2 Now change, remove the bracket, minus 53/10 plus 3/10. Take the LCM of these three, it is your 10. Divide 10 by 5, we have 2, 2 multiplied by 21, it's a 42, minus 53, why? Because 10 divided by 10, it's a 1, a 1. Multiplied 53, it's a 53 plus 2, 10 going to divide by 2, 5 into 3, 15. Huh? Now, here you have to follow. See, sign picked as it is given in the question. Huh? We have followed all the things. Now, add the numbers in numerator, add the numbers with same sign and subtract with different sign. So what we have equal to first place 42 plus 15 minus 53 by 10, it's a 7 5 57 minus 53 by 10, it's a 4 by 10. I think I'm. Is there any problem? So it's a 4/10. See here, 2 2s are 4 and 2 5s are 5. So we can write down it's a 2/5. So this is your simplification type question. That's all for today's work. All of you complete. All of you complete exercise 1B from 1 to question number 3. One question number 1 is of objective type question that you can do in your copy, but 2 and 3 you must question number 1 do in your book with pencil, but question number 2 and 3 must solve in your maths fair copy. Remember, you have to follow all the steps as I am discussing in the video. Need not to skip any step. If you have, you can understand it properly, or you are able to solve questions, it's good. You must comment in a comment part of this video so that I can understand. And remember, all of you must see the video completely, must subscribe my channel so that I can know how much of you are seeing the video. That's all for today. Thank you.